Problem number 48. Here we will talk about the scientific research and its misinterpretation or misuse. So the question related to problem number 48 is, can misuse of a research may be a reason for not doing it? Now here I will explain the misinterpretation of the results that is actually done by the scientist. Keep in mind that the misuse of the scientific research is not only occur at the commercial scale, rather misinterpretation is also termed as misuse that can occur in your own lab. Now there are number of reasons of misuse. Chahe scientist janbuch ke misuse kare scientific cheezon ka. Here dishonesty is another factor. Then accidental approach, or it can be a political pressure. Then ignorant or biased approach towards the scientific research. आप अपने कुछ subjects को importance देते हैं और कुछ subjects को importance नहीं देते. This is included in something you have done bias. Then some scientists are careless. Again, you are misinterpreting the scientific research. So all these factors are involved in the misinterpretation of the scientific research, and even the combination of these factors can be involved. Now keep in mind that no doubt research is about the doubt and certainty. It is about the complexity and simplicity. So there are some common ways that we have to consider while interpreting the scientific research data. And these common ways that are actually involved in misinterpretation of the scientific research by the scientist are flawed research, which is unfortunately very much common in Pakistan, using findings out of context, then stretching findings by making use of complex statistical methods, distorting findings again by using wrong stats, rejecting or ignoring findings of the scientific research. These are the common ways by which you can misinterpret the scientific research. Now let's discuss these common ways one by one, and the first common way is the flawed research. Now research has to be designed and it has to be carried out in a professional as well as in an ethical way. Because once you are not dealing with the ethics, for example, you are taking blood sample from the patient or from the human beings, here again bioethics is involved. Or you are performing experiments on animals, again ethical issues are involved. So you have to deal with the scientific research professionally as well as ethically, because all these factors impact the final quality of your findings. Now keep in mind that we have to understand the principles very well, because research design and its delivery is very important, because by this we can assess the research findings. And these are the important factors that we have to consider. Now the important questions that we have to look as a scientist while performing or while constructing the project, these are number one, aims and objectives of the research. Whenever you construct the abstract or your synopsis, it is based on different headings. First one is the background, then aims and objectives, then design, and then methodology, even research conclusion and the results. So here flawed research is based on all these headings. We have to look that whether the research aims are properly explained or not, that whether aims and objectives are clear to the researcher or not. Then method in which you have involved in the research article, it is clearly set out in the article or in the synopsis or not. Literature review should be relevant. Agar aapne literature review usse relevant nahi dala hua, then it is again a flawed research. इसके अलावा लिटरेचर रिव्यू इट शुड बी अप टू डेट. अगर आपने 1900s की रिसर्च अपने पेपर में डाली है तो उसके बाद से आप सोच लें कि कितना टाइम पीरियड और कितनी रिसर्च में बेनिफिशियल फॉर ह्यूमन बींग्स हो चुकी है. सो हेयर इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन सैम्पल साइज इज अगेन इम्पॉर्टेंट, दैट हाउ द सैम्पल इज कलेक्टेड एंड हाउ मच इज द सैम्पल इज कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट. बिकॉज इफ द सैम्पल साइज इज स्मॉल देन योर रिसर्च इज लैकिंग समथिंग. For example, if you are determining the association between two variables and your sample size is small, then you may not find the association between them. Agar aapne sample size badha liya, again might you get the association between those two variables. Then you have to check the accuracy of data return. Iske ilawa aapne dekhna hai ki aap apne data ko proceed aage karne ke liye क्या पूरी इंफॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल है या नहीं. रिजल्ट्स को कंपाइल करने के लिए यू हैव टू चूज द सिंपल स्टैटिस्टिकल मेथड्स. इसके अलावा आपने देखना है कि जो आपने इंटरप्रेट किया है अपनी रिसर्च फाइंडिंग्स को, क्या वो कंक्लूजन जस्टिफाइड हैं, क्या उनके एविडेंसेस आपके आर्टिकल साइनोप्सिस में अवेलेबल हैं या नहीं. The second common way by which you can misinterpret your data is using findings out of context. This is the most possible factor that enable the research to be successful, or this may be the most important factor that can hinder your research. Now here you have to look at your research plan, that how the work was planned. Then consultation is very important. For the researcher, as a researcher, you have to consult with the professors, with the supervisors, even with your colleagues. क्योंकि as a researcher, कोई नया idea आपके दिमाग में किसी time भी click कर सकता है by just sharing the research findings with other people. Then stretching findings, which is very commonly done by the researchers. Suppose आपके पास positive results आ गए हैं, then you stretch them or talk them in such a manner that you give them very significance or importance to those results. Iske ilawa stretching findings mein sample size bahut important hai. Small sample size rare diseases ke liye to acceptable hai, lekin jaise ki diabetes bahut common hai, then for such research which is performed on diabetic patients, here sample size should be to a limited number or to an extendable number, ताकि हम variables के दरमियान relationship find out कर सकें. Then distorting findings. This is commonly done by using the statistical methods. Always choose the simple statistical method that is easily understandable by the other scientist. Because scientist stats actually supports your viewpoint. Once you have applied the wrong statistics, you are actually distorting your results, you are distorting or damaging your findings. Another common way is rejecting and ignoring findings. This is the biggest problem. We have to balance the complex realities against the necessities of making decision. जैसे कि स्मोकिंग हमें 30 साल पहले भी मालूम थी, लेकिन आज भी स्मोकिंग के जरिए मिलियंस की तादाद में लोगों की डेथ्स हो रही हैं. इसकी सबसे बड़ी वजह यह है कि कमर्शियल प्रेशर है साइंटिस्ट पे, दे कांट स्टॉप द ग्रोथ ऑफ टोबैको क्रॉप्स. इसके अलावा पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर भी साइंटिस्ट पे है. सो दीज आर द फैक्टर्स दैट आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन रिजेक्टिंग एंड इग्नोरिंग फाइंडिंग्स. इसके अलावा वो रिसर्चर्स जो सोशल केयर एरिया में रिसर्च कर रहे हैं, दे हैव टू टेक ग्रेटर responsibility because they have to convert research findings into social policies that have to be established, implemented, and they have to be regulated. So the policy and their actions are very important for the social workers. Iske ilawa agar hum clinical practitioners ki baat karein, then they have to shape the research agenda according to the needs of their clients.